Welcome back to this special edition of CNT News. Of course, we are out at the BMX track.
Yeah, today, Tuesday, is the first official day of racing here at the track.
It starts with the challenge races. They will last until noon on Friday, and that features amateur racers, people who are as young as 5 years old.
It's hard to believe. CN2 sports reporter James Lamberts now has more of his in-depth interview with Mike King, who is the BMX coordinator for this championship week.
Each of these countries have done their qualification process. Each country has their own system. Team USA had four qualifying races throughout the country, where each race had eight qualifiers, so we had a total of 62 total for each of the 52 categories that we have in the UCI. Based on the schedule, it'll be broken down into groups. So our first day of competition will be on Tuesday. We'll have just the cruiser bikes, that's 24-inch wheels. Then the next day on Wednesday, we'll have the youngest kids, ages, I believe, 10, 11 and under. Then the following day, we'll have the medium age group kids, I believe 12 through 16. On Friday, we'll go with the bigger kids, the older amateurs, 17 and over. And then, of course, on Saturday night, we'll conclude with our elite and junior riders. Those are the ones that go to the Olympics and are the pro athletes from all over the world.
As a former BMX athlete, are you pumped about this week?
You know, I'm having a hard time sleeping, to be honest. I mean, I was very, very fortunate to be involved in this process. When I moved out here from California and I took on this job, that was one of the first things that we really wanted to do, is we wanted to get a really big event and to have that involvement and to say, you know, let's bring the world championships to Rock Hill, and let's put Rock Hill on not just the domestic cycling map, let's put it on a global map, and I think we've done that. But it hasn't been here since 2001. I've gone to the previous four world championships, and even when I was at USA Cycling managing the US team, I always had this mindset of, you know, how can we get the world championships back? And 3.5 years later, we're here.
And we are here indeed, and this place is absolutely packed.
James, this is so exciting. I cannot believe how many racers and families and fans are out here.
Yeah, such an experience. Now, you're holding the official trophy that the athletes, riders, will get when they finish their rides and win their heats and everything along those lines. And the cool thing about this trophy was designed right here in Rock Hill. So Rock Hill City officials designed this trophy. It has its own Rock Hill spin on it. So we really like that.
It really is so cool. The riders, this is what they're gunning for. I mean, they want to come home with these. So these competitors are here to win it, and it is so exciting. And again, we want to remind folks, especially in York County, that if you come out on Saturday, which is the day the Olympians are going to be here, it's free to all York County residents.
Absolutely. James, what's it like to hold the trophy?
It's actually not that heavy. So I would love to take it out and put it on one of my shelves back home. But
yeah, no kidding. All right, let's all put our hands on it. Look at that. Oh, my gosh. What a fantastic newscast from out here at the BMX track. We're so excited to show you all the ins and outs and some of the behind the scenes that you normally might not get to see this week, but definitely come out if you get a chance to see. This is a really once in a lifetime opportunity.
There is so much to see, to enjoy. Has it been fun to cover?
Absolutely. It's been action-packed, and the week's just getting started.
It's true. Well, we hope everyone enjoyed our special coverage out here from the BMX event. Again, the world is watching, and we are so happy to be hosting.
Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you.
Good night.